Morning students, welcome to online class. Today I am going to explain exercise 3.1 second sum or B. third sum C. Construct a parallelogram with PQRS with PQ equals to 4.5 centimeters, QR equals to 3 centimeters, and PQR is equals to 60 degrees. Construct a parallelogram. Okay. When you construct the parallelogram, how many measurements are required already on table is given in the previous class. Okay, how many measurements are required? 3 measurements are required. So here 3 measurements are given. But actually, if you have quadrilateral construction, okay, how many measurements are required to construct a quadrilateral? 5 measurements. Okay, but here 3 measurements is given. But we need 5 measurements. Okay, parallelogram also a quadrilateral. So, if a quadrilateral construction required 5 measurements, where is the remaining 2 measurements? How to find the remaining 2 measurements? What is the diagram? Parallelogram. In a parallelogram, what are the properties? I said properties also. Okay. What are the properties of parallelogram? Opposite sides are equal. Opposite sides are equal. Opposite sides are equal. So here the rough diagram is PQ. PQ equals to 4.5 centimeters. QR. QR equals to 3 centimeters. R. Okay. Yes. Yes. This is 60 degrees. So, in PQRS, PQ equals to 4.5 centimeters is given, QR equals to 3 centimeters is given. So, the opposite side, what is the PQ opposite side? PQ equals to, RS equals to 4.5 centimeters. 4.5 centimeters. So, 2 measurements. Next, QR. What is the opposite side of QR? PS. PS is also equals to 3 centimeters. 3 centimeters. So 4 measurements came. And one other one is angle PQR. Angle PQR is equals to 60 degrees. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 measurements. Okay. So we given 3 measurements. But we will try to write the 5 measurements by using the properties of parallelogram. Okay. Now construct the parallelogram. How to construct the parallelogram? Here, okay, write the first steps. What is the step 1? Draw a rough diagram. draw a rough diagram. That is the first step. Second one. Okay. First step. Draw a line segment. PQ equals to 4.5 centimeters. Draw a line segment. PQ equals to 4.5 centimeters with the help of scale. Okay. This is PQ 4.5 centimeters. Okay. Draw a line segment PQ equals to 4.5 centimeters. Next. Okay. PQ. Okay, QR is given. So, from in the QR, Q point you know. So, with QA center, QR equals to 3 centimeters. Draw an arc with the help of compass. Okay. With QA center, with QA center, okay, QR equals to 3 centimeters, draw an arc, okay, next step, say PSL, which point you know, P point, so from P, with PS center, PQ, PS equals to 3 centimeters, Draw an arc. With QA center, QR equals to 3 centimeters, draw an arc. And with PS center, PS equals to 3 centimeters, draw an arc. Okay. Third point. With QA center, QR equals to 3 centimeters, draw an arc. Next, the fourth one. Same. With that, later I will write that one. Okay, next step. We don't know the values, the points of R and S. We don't know. Okay, so you will not take the R is 4.7. Where is R and where is S? We don't know the points. And QR completed, PQ completed, QR completed. Okay. PS also completed. Okay. PS, this one. QR, this one. PQ, this one. How to find the R and S points? We don't know. Now, angle PQR equals to 60 degrees is given. Okay. Already I told you how to construct the angle 60 degrees without using protractor by using only compass. Okay. Look at the board. See the children. Take some radius as your wish. Draw an arc. Okay, with the same radius, draw an arc from where cut the line segment. Okay, one is enough. That angle is 60 degrees. Join Q and the intersecting point. Q and the intersecting point. Okay. Q क्यू एक्स, हाउ मच एंगल, दिस इज 60 डिग्रीज। फोर्थ वन, विथ क्यू एस सेंटर क्यू एक्स रे मेकिंग एन एंगल ऑफ 60 डिग्रीज, ओके, जिसके क्यू इज 60 डिग्रीज एंगल, ओके, दिस क्यू एक्स रे एंड द आर्क क्यू आर आर्क इंटरसेक्ट एट ए पॉइंट, द पॉइंट इज आर, पी क्यू आर, ओके, दिस आर्क एंड रे इंटरसेक्ट एट ए पॉइंट, एट ए पॉइंट आर। Now you know the point of R. Okay. Next. Now, with PS center, PS equals to 3 centimeters. With PS center, PS equals to 3 centimeters. Draw an arc. Okay. PS enter, draw one arc. Now, PS completed, PQ completed, QR completed, PQR completed. Angle. Now, what is RS? In RS equals to 4.5 centimeters. You know the point R. So, with RS enter, RS equals to 4.5 centimeters, draw an arc. RS. R S from R and S. Okay. P S arc, R S arc intersect at a point. P S, R S. So S point come. So this point is S. Seventh one. With RS center, RS equals to 4.5 centimeters, draw an arc. With RS center, RS equals to 4.5 centimeters, draw an arc. Now, these points intersect. These arcs intersect at a point S. These two arcs, PS arc and RS arc, intersect at a point S. Now, join PS and RS. Okay, join PS and RS. Okay, these two line segments are joined. Okay, PS and RS. Now, the quadrilateral is parallelogram. Therefore, PQRS is a required parallelogram. Required parallelogram. PQRS is a required parallelogram. So, RS 4.5 centimeters. PS 4 centimeters. This is the QR 3 centimeters. This is also 3 centimeters. This is the required parallelogram. Okay. This is the construction of parallelogram and the steps. Okay, next. D sum. Construct a rhombus. Construct a rhombus. Math. With AT. Equals to 4 centimeters, angle MAT equals to 120 degrees. Okay, when you construct a rhombus, how many measurements are required? I already gave the table. So a rhombus construction may require two measurements only. Okay, given two measurements. But actually, to construct a quadrilateral, how many measurements are required? 5 measurements. Rhombus is also a quadrilateral. So, we need 5 measurements are required to construct a rhombus. Where is the remaining 3 measurements? Okay, by using the properties, in a rhombus, what are the first, what is the first property? All sides are equal. All sides are equal. So, AT equals to 4 centimeters. Then, MA, AT, TH, MH. These are the four sides. Z equals to 4 centimeters. So, four sides and one angle. Angle MAT equals to 120 degrees. Okay. Look at the AT is given. So, AT, sub diagram. Okay, AT equals to 4 centimeters. MAT, angle A, 120 degrees. So this is 120 degrees. MATH. 4 centimeters, 4 centimeters, 4 centimeters, angle A 120 degrees. That is the top diagram. So, MA equals to 4 centimeters, AT equals to 4 centimeters, TH equals to 4 centimeters, MH is also equals to 4 centimeters. Angle MAT is equals to 120 degrees. This is the top diagram. Okay, now, steps. First one is draw a rough diagram. That is first one. Second one. Okay. Choose any one of the side here. Okay. First MA math MA. I will take the MA. Draw a line segment. MA equals to 4 centimeters. M A 4 centimeters. Okay, now after that M A or A T. A T is given, so A T. Okay, AT equals to 4 centimeters. Now, with AA center, the angle A equals to 120 degrees is given. So, angle A 120 degrees with the help of compass. How to construct the angle 120 degrees with the help of compass? First, take some convenient radius as your wish and draw an arc. Draw one arc like this. Okay. With the same radius, where the cutter, the arc to line segment, in that with that point is a center, draw another arc. That is 60, and the 60 from 60 draw another arc. That is 120. Okay. Join this 120 and A with the help of scale. Second step, with A as center, first draw a line segment AT equals to, AT equals to 4 centimeters. Third one, with A as center, AX-ray making an angle of 120 degrees. Okay, now AT 120 degrees. Now with AS center, okay, MATH, compass. So M point, A point. MA equals to, you know the A point, you don't know the M point. So MA equals to 4 centimeters. This is the 4 centimeters. So with the AA center, draw one arc. With AA center, MA is equals to 4 centimeters, draw an arc. This arc and this ray intersect at a point. This arc and ray intersect at a point M. The point is M. Now, with the center T, MATH is also 4 centimeters. So TH 4 centimeters, draw an arc, and MH is also 4 centimeters. So with MS center, MH equals to 4 centimeters, draw an arc. Okay, the MH arc and TH arc intersect at a point H. Sixth point is, with T as center, TH equals to 4 centimeters, draw an arc. Again, with MS center, with MS center, MH equals to 4 centimeters, draw another arc, draw an arc. 8 1. These two arcs intersected. These two arcs intersected at a point, that point is H. These two arcs intersect at a point H. Ninth one, join TH and MH. TH and MH. Join TH. And MH. Join TH and MH. MATH is the required rhombus. Okay, this is 120. This is 4 centimeters, and this is 4 centimeters, and this is 4 centimeters. This is the rhombus construction. Okay, thank you, students. Tomorrow we will discuss about the next E and F sums. Okay, today I gave the homework is exercise 3.1. B sum. This is HW. Thank you, students.